All right, so next up with this thing, we're going to pull the oil pan off and modify the OEM windage tray and the OEM oil pan. So as I'm taking it apart, I got to measure a couple things to see what I have for space. But since this thing's been on the OEM pan, OEM pickup, and the OEM windage tray / oil pan gasket, these things are made with them in one piece. They're pretty cool pieces if you haven't seen them before. Above like 8200, 8300, it's had some windage problems. Oil pressure falls from like mid-80s down to 60 or so. So in an effort to try to prevent that, we're going to do some stuff there. And for now, what I've been doing for the last season is I added this Accusump, which if you're not familiar with an Accusump, it's basically, you can see it's got 100 pounds of pressure in it on this gauge. So it fills this cylinder up with oil. And this measures the air pressure on the other side of the oil. So when engine oil pressure falls underneath that, this piston moves, right? And forces oil pressure back into the oiling system. So I've been using that to cover up both the potential oiling problems from the G-force at the hit. This car does pull just over 2G at the hit on a radial tire. And to cover up the oil pressure issues at the higher RPM range. We've been going through the traps at like 9,300. So anyway, let's get it up in the air and get the pan off. All right, we got the K-member off. We got the oil pan off, obviously. Everything under here looking good yet. So I'm gonna mock up the pan windage tray pickup setup on the old stock engine out of this thing, actually, and show you guys what I'm doing. All right, so I got the old stock engine here all wrapped up so we don't get stuff in it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna screen. So basically what's going on is the engine rotates this direction. Right. If you look here, I mean, you know how big the crankshaft counterweights are and that kind of stuff, right? So that makes a lot of air. What that's called is called windage. So what happens is it's basically the crankshaft's covered in oil and it's spraying that oil everywhere. And if you don't have good control of that, the air coming through here comes in here at a really fast rate, right? So the windage can disrupt not only the oil drain back to the sump of the pan, which should typically, you know, which is here, but also, it can just aggravate the oil that's already in the sump because the air is moving so quickly right over the sump here that if this stuff isn't controlled, it could just blow the oil away from the pickup in some instances. But the biggest thing is really it gets aerated because it's traveling so fast. We got to try to separate the air from it and just control the windage in the tank, in the oil pan better. You can see these things are pretty cool. So these are the oil drain passages. So they're completely isolated. Other than that, this wind coming through here is coming right into those, right? So we got to slow that air down. So I'm going to do that with some screen. I got some Moroso screen. They sell like just a generic windage tray material. So I'm going to get that fastened on there and show you what that looks like. So here's the windage tray. It is done. I don't have all the bolts in it. So here's the scraper. I want to show you this side of it first. This is obviously the bottom side of the engine is upside down. So these are drains from the scraper side of it. I'll show you what that means. And this mesh is just to slow the air down as it goes through the windage tray and also separate oil from the air as the oil would hit that mesh and fall out of suspension. So roll it over here, give you a better idea. See, so there's a crank scraper. See how that mesh works on the windage tray there and the scraper. See, I got just some holes I popped in it there for drain, and that's why these are cut out. On the back side there, like I showed you. So that's it for the windage tray. Onto the oil pan and pickup. You can see I cut the front of it out already. I'm gonna cut this section out here, this back section. Cut this out. This is where the pickup sits currently. I'm gonna move it back 2 inches. That'll put it about 3.5 inches from the back of the pan. And that's just better for the acceleration G-forces, making sure the pickup stays in the oil. Kind of deal. Obviously on severe D-cell, it's kind of hurting us, but look at how far forward that thing is now. So I think it'll work well. We're gonna cut that out and get that moved. All right, pan's done, painted on there. Pull it off of here real quick. The whole oiling system is now ready. So there's the windage tray. I gotta finish putting the rest of the bolts in it. Pickups move 2 inches back. Height is set. So now I just gotta put all the bolts in the windage tray and put it back on the car.